Paris. New breakthroughs in COVID-related medicine, and this time it's a pill. Pharmaceutical companies Pfizer and Merck have been working on antiviral pills that fight COVID-19. Merck's pill was authorized in the United Kingdom just last week, and Pfizer says it plans to send the results of its clinical trials to the U.S. Food and Drug Administration. The company claims it reduces the risk of hospitalization or death by 89%. Joining us now with more is Dr. Irfan Hafiz, infectious disease specialist and chief medical officer of Northwestern Medicine, McHenry, Huntley, and Woodstock Hospitals. Dr. Hafiz, thank you so much for joining us. So we understand that Merck's pill has been approved in the UK. Pfizer, no authorization for that one yet. How do both of these pills work?
Yeah, these are both antiviral agents. It's very exciting to hear that we're finally being able to get these through the trials there. Both of these work slightly differently. The Merck's drug actually is a nucleoside analog, so it works earlier in the phase of where the virus infects the cell. Pfizer's drug, on the other hand, is a protease inhibitor. We've used protease inhibitors for decades for other viral treatments, but this one is part of the life cycle of the virus, actually before it leaves the host cell. So both of them can, at different targets, affect the cell replication.
And how would you say their effectiveness compares to one another?
There is, right now, the trials are not head-to-head trials, so it's really hard to compare them. Both of them seem to be quite efficacious. The Merck's trial, it says it's about 50% ability to reduce hospitalization if given within 5 days of onset of symptoms. Pfizer's drug, on the other hand, is claiming 89%, as you mentioned on the opening, if given within 3 days, however. So they're both highly effective. I'm sure we're going to hear more as time goes on with really what the head-to-head comparison looks like.
And these are, they're both a course of pills, correct?
Correct. Both of them are 5-day treatments that need to be started preferably within 3 days. Right now, Pfizer's looks like up to 5 days of symptoms is possible. The sooner you get treated, the better. This is really before you're hospitalized. By the time you're hospitalized, these antiviral drugs are probably too late to do any good.
Okay. So Pfizer's CEO, Albert Bourla, spoke about the pill. Here's what he said.
And not everybody are getting the vaccines. So this is why we have this unfortunate situation that our ICUs in hospitals is overcrowded by unfortunate people that are getting the COVID. Now we have a solution for that. And this is exactly where it fits. This is not to prevent at this stage COVID. This is to treat those that unfortunately got the disease.
And just to be clear, at the top of that soundbite, he says not everybody is getting the vaccines. And so officials, of course, doctor, still recommend the vaccine, not, you know, waiting to get sick so that you can just take the pill, correct?
Correct. I mean, the vaccine is definitely the first means of treatment there and prevention, really. So you don't want to get into that situation. So definitely encourage vaccination. It's for those people who either cannot get vaccinated or have breakthrough infections that these antiviral drugs will be of really great benefit.
And what do you think so far is the timeline for either the Merck or the Pfizer pill being available in the U.S.?
Probably it may be in the next month to 2 months. I think there will be some emergency use authorization, EUA, as it's called, from the FDA as well. I do believe that these drugs will play a big role, and there will probably be other drugs that will be similar as well coming down through the development pipeline there. But these drugs will probably be fast-tracked by the FDA.
And of course, you know, is a patient eligible to receive the course twice? For example, if you get COVID in January and are given the pill, and then, you know, several months later, if you should happen to get it again, would the pill still be effective?
Yeah, probably yes. It should work. I think that's one of the key points there is that, unlike vaccination, the pills are not going to provide any long-lasting immunity. They're going to help curb the onset of symptoms, reduce the severity for that round of infection. It will not prevent the next infection and therefore may have to be used again.
Okay. Now, the U.S. is paying $712 per patient for Merck's drug, and that's what's been negotiated. How does that price translate to consumers?
Really hard to say at this point. It'd be difficult to say. I saw some numbers of around $700 for the Pfizer drug. But this was based on some UK pricing that I saw in an article. But I don't know what the eventual retail cost will be.
Okay, and that seems like a high amount. Surely, you know, less wealthy nations won't be expected to negotiate that same amount. I think they've negotiated some generics.
Correct. There's probably going to be, this will definitely limit who's going to be able to get the drug for sure. The cost is quite a bit.
Absolutely. And to that end, you know, will there likely be some guidance on who is eligible or who would benefit from receiving this treatment? For example, we know early on, you know, older people, those who are immunocompromised, were first in line for the vaccine, for example.
Absolutely. Just as we have for the monoclonal antibody, there are some criteria for usage. Similarly for this, I do expect that there will be some usage criteria as well. But this gets back to really the importance of vaccination as that cost-effective way. This the highest, if you look at cost-effectiveness and the benefit ratio, it is the highest with vaccines. So okay. It's hard to beat.
Yeah. Dr. Irfan Hafiz, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.